This is a game where we did not show enough competitiveness. I think, as you said, in the past, we have known that we played good cricket even when we've lost and we've been in the game. But I think we let ourselves down massively in the first innings with the bat. You could say that the toss, you know, played a big role in this test match, but it's an uncontrollable. So you can't really focus on that and take that as a massive factor. But having said that, I think the first innings, our performance really pushed us back. We knew the conditions are going to keep getting better. So if you get 232, 240 in the first innings of the test match, then you're giving your bowlers a chance, and then your second innings, you know, deficit also becomes smaller. So I think all these things, we have to understand that we were not at our best in this game, and there is no shame or no harm in accepting that, absolutely. And only when we accept this, we will come out in the next game with a much better mindset and much better competitiveness that we have shown as a team, and that is actually the representation of this test team, the way we play our cricket, and we have to take a lot of pride in that, and this game wasn't that example.
How do you like decide when to attack? And at one point it looked like you were happy that Rahane was going after. So how do you just deal with it?
Look, you have to try and get into a positive frame of mind. I think in test cricket in general, you have to be in a very clear state of mind. You can't really play at home also. You can't really play a lot of shots. You can't just say that I'm going to smash the ball from ball one. You have to choose what kind of ball you want to hit, even on turning tracks. That's the key to... But you also have to maintain that intent where you are putting those boundary balls away. I think we have to accept and understand that New Zealand bowled really, really well in this test match, both the innings. Although, you know, first innings there was a bit more assistance. But in the second innings, I think that's been their strength. They put fielders accordingly. They get into the mind of the batsman and then, you know, make the batsman do something that they don't want to. I think that's a very thin line and a very delicate balance when to attack and when to put the bowler under pressure, which we failed to do in this match. And there's no harm in accepting that. We have done that on many occasions. But this was a test match where we were not able to do it. That has to do with partly good bowling from New Zealand and partly us not, you know, pressing that momentum onto them when required. So I think it was perfect for them because they bowled well and we allowed them to bowl well for longer periods rather than, you know, doing something about it in a partnership. So as you said, when Jinx started and, you know, the plan was to just go positive, if we both add 70, 80 positively, then the game changes. You have to take those chances. Sometimes they don't come off. But if you try and do that for longer periods, they do tend to come off and, you know, the situation changes, which we have addressed already and something that we will keep in our mind going forward.